going up at 12:30 to give it to the mayor. So please fill it out, pass it around. Thank you.
Para los que hablan español, también tenemos una versión en español. Es el presupuesto para la humanidad, no la brutalidad. Y tenemos en la parte de atrás, hay unas demandas que estamos haciendo. Y si pueden utilizar unas de estos ejemplos, o pongan lo que ustedes sientan que necesita esta ciudad. Gracias.
Montana with
Senior and Disability Action. And we're here today with over 30 organizations demanding for a fair budget, right? We don't want a budget cut on us. We need to make sure that our basic human needs are protected and that the mayor and the Board of Supervisors don't pin our needs together, but actually support our budget ask. We are a budget justice coalition of over 30 organizations. BJC, make some noise! Woo! So we're here today to, I guess, tell the mayor and the Board of Supervisors we need a budget to help staff and assistants stay in the city. Earlier today, we were with Miss Iris Canada right across the street, a 99-year-old woman who's being evicted. Ooh, right? That's how bad greed is inflicting in San Francisco, and that is not the San Francisco we know.
No, we don't.
Yeah, so we're here because we really want our mayor and our supervisors to listen to us. It's time for them to make the right decisions. So increase our budget. Give us the needs that we have. We have one of the richest cities in the world, and we still have people that need so many services and don't get them. So let's start with this, and let's do some chants. Okay, so I'm going to say, what do we want? And you guys are going to say, stop the budget cut. And when do we want it? Now. Right now. Okay. So what do we want?
Stop the budget cut.
When do we want it?
Now. Right now.
What do we want?
Stop the budget cut.
When do we want it?
Now.
Humanity, not brutality. Budget for humanity, not brutality. Budget for humanity,
not brutality.
Budget for humanity,
not brutality.
Budget for humanity,
not brutality.
All right, I would like to call up our first speaker. She's a strong woman organizer from the Coalition of Homelessness, who is a single mother with children in San Francisco and have experienced homelessness. We would like to call up Regina Bates on the mic. Make
I am here today. My name is Regina Bates. I'm a peer organizer working at Coalition of Homelessness in Tampa, Heather. I help families find resources to help them get out of this situation. I was previously homeless for about 3 years with my young daughter. And it was the worst and best thing that ever happened to me. While staying in the shelter, I was able to access resources to help me overcome this epidemic. By all means necessary, voice your concerns. Advocate for yourself and others along this journey. Let your test be your testimony.
Right.
We must fight together, keep marching, keep talking, keep shouting from the rooftop. Even if you don't have a rooftop, the sky is your rooftop, okay? To get our voices heard and money for homeless families to reach their full potential in life. Now, you're going to ask me, how do we do this, Regina? How can this be done? Well, what we're asking Mayor Lee and the supervisors here in the City Hall of San Francisco, which I allow the epidemic. What we want is a sustainable revenue to house the homeless population in San Francisco. What is a just budget? We're asking Mayor Lee and the Board of Supervisors to fund the subsidy. See, that's where I come in at, because I got housed August last year. If it wasn't for these subsidies, I would still be homeless. Okay? Now, you say, how much would the costing of the subsidies, how much would it cost in the budget? It's only 3% of the budget. Equals $12 million a year. Okay? Look at this picture. From downtown Frisco all the way to Silicon Valley, there's millions and billions of dollars being spent on these buildings. Okay? Why you can't spend 3% of the budget to house the homeless people? Alright, now, just to reflect the needs of the homeless people in the city, if you're really going to help people, like, get off the street, you're going to make this a priority. Alright, we're asking Mayor Lee and the supervisor to put a permanent solution on a plague that has encountered our city that we love. Why are we asking him? So everyone can have a decent place to live. That's how you, like a root in a tree. You see what I'm saying? The house is the root right there. Okay? Now, how can kids flourish and earn their full potential in this life if they ain't got nowhere to go? Nowhere to stay. Okay? That's how the fruit falls from the tree. All right? So you guys, do your best. We ask you for your support. Thank you for being out here today. God be with you. We're going to do this.
If you go to the fourth chat, we're going to say number four. When family rights are under attack, what do we do?
Stand up under attack.
When family rights are under attack, what do we do?
Stand up under attack.
Great. We have a great leader here from the Spanish community. This is Guillermina. Guillermina Castellanos is a great, great leader that is part of our community, and we want her to stay in the community. She's going to talk about our housing issues and worker issues in San Francisco.
Buenas tardes, ¿qué pasa? Que nos escuchen, alcalde. Que nos escuchen, alcalde. Que necesitamos un presupuesto para vivienda. Necesitamos un presupuesto para la salud. Necesitamos un presupuesto para los inquilinos que no sean desalojados.
Así es.
We want the mayor to hear us. We need money, we need budget for housing, we need budget for medical, we need budget for workers.
We need budget.
Oh, and we need money for education.
Claro, okay. Pues soy Guillermina Castellanos y trabajo con la colectiva de mujeres y el Day Labor. Para nosotros es sumamente importante que el alcalde ponga mucha atención a este presupuesto, porque está viendo mucha gente desalojada. Estoy viendo cada día que nuestras miembros no asisten a las reuniones porque las están desalojando a San Pablo, a Richmond, a otras. Eso no es justo.
We need the mayor to listen to us. I cannot believe we've seen our co-workers being evicted. They have to move to San Pablo, to Oakland, to many other cities because they cannot afford to live here and they've been evicted. The mayor needs to hear us.
Señor alcalde Lee, es importante el suicidio de vivienda, albergues, emergencias, prevención a los desalojos para alcanzar los derechos de los inquilinos y un refugio para los más necesitados y un proyecto piloto para restaurar las vidas de cada uno de nuestros miembros de la comunidad.
Mr. Mayor Lee, it's necessary for you to put money to continue funding housing
emergency refugees, as well as... And stop the evictions.
Queremos proteger los derechos de los trabajadores, el empleo, y dar otras oportunidades para la gente de bajos ingresos, para luchar sobre salarios no pagados y casos que están en desarrollo y la fuerza laboral para nuestra comunidad. Es una...
We need to protect workers' rights and give more opportunities of employment to people of low income, and also we need to fight for wage tax and also manage the cases of developing workforces.
Nuestra comunidad necesita presupuesto para vivienda, trabajo, no para que nos estén matando a nuestra comunidad. Ya estamos cansados. Señor Lee, alcalde, o como me quiera entender, necesitamos un presupuesto digno para toda nuestra comunidad. No importa género, raza, religión, lo que importa es que necesitamos ese presupuesto digno para toda nuestra comunidad latina inmigrante. Ya basta de tanta brutalidad policíaca. Queremos luchar y vamos a continuar luchando por este presupuesto que bien merecido no lo tenemos. ¿Se puede?
¡Sí se puede!
¿Se puede?
¡Sí se puede!
¿Se puede?
¡Sí se puede!
¡Hasta la victoria! Continuaremos luchando por ese presupuesto digno. ¡Gracias!
Okay, that's hard to follow. So she said, Mr. Mayor, Mayor Lee, whatever you want me to call you, we need you to put more money for our communities, to pay for new jobs, to give money for education. We don't want our community to be killed. You know, we need a dignity budget, not a brutality, you know, so we kind of do that. We have that, so we have the chance. Budget for humanity, not brutality. So budget for humanity,
not brutality.
Budget for humanity,
not brutality.
So she said, si se puede, and everybody knows that. Si se puede, right?
Si se puede.
He works for us. That the Board of Supervisors works for us. And today I have one of the supervisors here who is working with the people. I would like to call up Supervisor John Avalos.
Thank you for being here, Budget Justice Coalition. Thank you for your work on the budget. San Francisco is in a crisis. When I got on the board, San Francisco was a crisis. 7 years ago, we were in a crisis. We had, our economy had tanked. We had a budget deficit of $500 million. The city was facing all kinds of cuts. Our poor people who are living in poverty in San Francisco were seeing fewer and fewer opportunities to get out of poverty. And now 7 years later, we have the most unprecedented wealth in the city. We have the tech sector thriving, at the same time ravaging San Francisco's affordability. We've seen the wealth of our communities, the little wealth that we have, shift up to the highest economic brackets. That's happening all over the country, but it's happening here in San Francisco more than any other place in the country. We fought in 2011 in the Occupy movement for the 99%, and And I'm afraid to say that we have not been successful in that fight, is that 1% has swelled with wealth and taken it from our community. So we see that if not managed properly, wealth can ravage a city just as much as poverty. And that's why we're here today, because whatever is decided on this budget, that is what we put forward as the values of San Francisco. And if we are putting forward the values of San Francisco, then we're going to make the comfortable even more comfortable at the expense of people who are not living with comfort in San Francisco, then we are putting forward a budget of tragedy. Again. So what's at stake now is to make sure that our voices can be strong and solid to influence what the mayor puts in his budget, because what the mayor puts in his budget is worth $9 billion compared to what the Board of Supervisors puts in our budget that we tweak with the mayor is more like $25 million difference. $9 billion versus $25 billion. The greater share of what we can do to have a budget that reflects the values of all of San Francisco is to make sure the mayor is hearing from us and can adjust the budget with our input and our voices. Are you up for the challenge? Are we going to fight for a budget that is for the people of San Francisco? Are we going to fight for a budget of justice? Thank you.
From the co-chair of HIV Care Council. Let's give it up for him.
Thank you. My name is Chip Spanish. I'm co-chair of the HIV Health Services Planning Council, also of the Mayor's Disability Council, and I'm a member of the Long-Term Care Council, which coordinates care for people with disabilities and seniors. I have several things I'd like to ask the mayor for today, but first of all, I'd like to talk about populations that are most vulnerable to HIV. We are seeing increasing rates of infection among women of color, young men of color, Latinos, transgender folks, and we need services for these communities. They are disenfranchised, they are put aside, shoved aside, and it's time for them to get care. People who are growing older with HIV have a whole combination of challenges and problems due to mental health conditions, physical conditions, poverty, stigma. These things need to be dealt with. So I'd like to see housing. Housing is something we all need, but people aging with HIV are particularly vulnerable because they live on disability, and if they are kicked out of their houses, they are homeless. They have nowhere to go.
Yes.
So also, we need eviction protection for low-income seniors, families, people with HIV. We need to provide for our neighbors, for our brothers and sisters, for the people who voted the board in and the mayor in. They are being forgotten, left behind, and they are suffering. So I'm asking Mayor Lee to please fund services for our brothers and sisters, our neighbors, and our friends with HIV, with housing challenges, with health challenges, with substance use challenges. These folks need to be included in your budget. Thank you very much.
He is an SRO tenant and a housing activist.
and he is working in a project related to elevators, and he knows about elevators, so give it up for him.
Hey, San Francisco, how are you today? I live in an SRO on 6th Street, and today I've been asked to talk about the elevators there.
Come on now.
The elevators, if they work, are really in serious need of some upgrades. And let me explain to you what it's like for me when my elevator goes down. I live on the 7th floor, so I have a penthouse. I overlook the Seneca Hotel. By the time I get to the 3rd floor, I'm clutching my chest and I'm ready to purr.
Come on now.
By the time I get to the 5th floor, it's like, Elizabeth, I'm coming for you.
Okay.
I'm coming, Elizabeth.
Come on now. That's true.
And I'm afraid that I'm gonna either have a heart attack or I'm gonna be so exhausted that I fall back down the stairs. We seriously need some elevator upgrades. We're asking that we get some money in the budget to do these elevator upgrades. These hotels that we're living in, that we're shuffled into as low-income residents, are sometimes over 100 years old. So we just can't get around. We have people in wheelchairs that if our elevator goes out, they're not going to get down the stairs. If they're in a motorized wheelchair, it's even worse. They can't be firemen carried down these stairs. If we have fire drills at my SRO hotel, I stay in my room because I know it wouldn't do me any good. I'd be dead by the smoke inhalation trying to get down the stairs. My best bet would be to try to hit a fire escape, and hopefully there'll be somebody outside to rescue me in a ladder or ladder truck or something like that. It's a big thing. And another thing I was asked to speak about was the in-home support services, and I received that also. And we're asking also for $2 million to help with the help seniors with their in-home support services. There are days where I can't hardly get out of bed. Luckily today was one of those that I could be able to speak to you good people. Or they couldn't get here to do this. It's like a lot of us are in walkers or use canes or we get around. We need to be able to have access to our homes and live comfortably. Thanks.
All right.
When seniors' rights are under attack, what do we do?
Stand up,
fight
back!
When seniors' rights are under attack, what do we do?
Stand up, fight back!
What do we do?
Stand up, fight back!
What do we do?
Stand up, fight back!
All right, thank you, everyone. Our last speaker who's going to take us out, please stick around. We're going to go inside City Hall and drop off our community demands to the mayor. So we'd love to have you there. Our last speaker is Tavi from Lyric. Let's give it up to her.
Hey, I'm here with the Budget Justice Coalition.
Woo-hoo!
On behalf of Lyric. It's important to have a budget ask in support of our collective liberation. And what is that I'm going to tell you about today? That's what I'm going to tell you about today. You can call me Tavi. I'm a white passing Chicana trans important that we collectively demand a just budget for everyone, not just some, because our organizations are working with different communities that intersect and fill different niches. But we complement each other. We pair well together, you know. I also want to name that we are on Yolamu Ohlone land. Not that a budget would ever address this, because then the system would fall apart. The Ohlone people are still here and need to be acknowledged. You can start by paying the Sumi land tax. Look it up. The Budget Justice Coalition will support queer and trans futures through internal paid leadership development opportunities. The case and case management services that meet the needs of our community. This is crucial because with a path to leadership, we can take hold of our own destiny and not have trans-misogynist white supremacy take lead. Kayona, giving me life from beyond, was just murdered in D.C. Say her name. Kayona.
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 This violence is happening to black and brown trans femmes here in Frisco and everywhere. Lyric is helping end this violence. So is TGI Justice Project and Ella Para Trans Latinas and Tanya's Coalition. We demand the Board of Supervisors and Mayor support the whole budget ask of the Budget Coalition and not pick it apart. Thank you.
Budget for humanity. Budget for humanity.
Not brutality.
A little louder, folks. Budget for humanity.
Not brutality.
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 When transgender's rights are under attack, what do we do?
Stand up, fight back.
When transgender's rights are under attack, what do we do?
Stand up, fight back.
What do we do?
Stand up, fight back.
What do we do?
Stand up, fight back.
Yes, we need to stand up and fight for each other's rights.
Yeah.
We need to collectively come together. And this is what the Budget Justice Coalition is about, bringing different people from different issues to come together and not be pinned against each other.
Right?
Because everybody's needs, from immigrants to tenants to workers, are all our needs. Those are basic human needs. And we need to stand up against the mayor's inequality propaganda to make sure that we stay here in San Francisco and that there's more affordable housing for us and that basic things like the elevator are fixed properly, right? So before we go in, please make sure you fill out the budget justice demand. They're all around. I have some more here. But we also want to take a picture, because if you look around, there's so much diversity here. And this is the real San Francisco. So we would like to take a coalition photo, so not just so the mayor can remember us, but look at us to know that this is the real San Francisco. And that we want the mayor and the Board of Supervisors to pass the $59 million budget demand of the Budget Justice Coalition
that covers budget requests from homelessness to shelters to families to transitional age youth to the Soma Filipinas to the child care to everybody's needs. So please come together and we're going to take a collective photo and then we're going to go in. Are you excited to go inside?
And then think about that sacred city supervisor that represents you.
And then we're going to just go say hello.